Welcome back, everybody. Ludi Farm Guy here for episode 10 of the $6 Million Farmer. And here we are. Our wheat is ready to harvest. We've been very busy at the farm. And so we start because I am the $6 million farmer. Yes. Well, we have lots of work today. We've been very busy, very, very busy. But we have planted our soybeans. We went back with soybeans because it pays a lot. It doesn't take any fertilizer. As you can see, nitrogen, perfect. It's zero. I don't have any nitrogen in the ground, but soybeans don't need nitrogen. So, no fertilizer. Awesome. Saves me money. Well, it doesn't really. I mean, I can use a fertilizer. Well, the grass takes a ton of fertilizer every time we harvest it. But anyways, yes, we've made a few changes. We're going to get this fellow started first. Lower that down a little bit. There we go. Let's do... Oh, we need straw. So we'll let this guy, and we're going to, we're not getting very much straw off this wheat. That's, maybe it's okay. I was getting a ton of straw off the barley. Like oodles we have. If we want to, look at our, straw is nearly full on there, and TMR, our straw is nearly full there, and yeah, so we got a ton of straw. We're going to get some more off of this, obviously, and I thought I'd bale it for a change. Kind of tired of picking it up. Whoops. yield looks pretty good on this, though. Let's just do a headland here. I'm probably going to get full before I end. Go to the end. I won't drop any straw here. It's just annoying. We're going to get... we're going to make bales for a change. Like I said, I've been tired of picking up straw. There's a few things I have done. Well, obviously, we went ahead in time. We did another grass harvest, and that's working out like pretty good. I have changed up. Well, we will go through this. I mean, things are always happening and changing. I don't really want things to stagnate here on the farm. We as the collective, the farm collective, want to keep things hip and happening. I think we're going to think about I'm getting behind myself or ahead of myself, one or the other, but I've turned off weeds. It was just extremely annoying. The spot weeders that I had were snail-like, sloth-like in their operation, and it was just painful. And you weren't watching. I mean, I wouldn't torture you through that anyways. It was just so slow and painful. It didn't cost a lot because it was spot spraying, and it didn't use up a lot of, but the worker, I mean, paying the workers to go through it, like it probably would have, it would take me a good hour of real time to spray all these fields for weeds with those sprayers. It's just, and I wasn't going to go get a regular sprayer that goes faster because it would give me slam me for the environmental scores. So you know what? I turned off the weeds. And if we go, I don't know why my score is so low, 81. We got an 89 here, 97, 98, 98, and a 96. So why is my total environmental total score so low? I don't get that. My fields are rocking. The lowest score is 89, and I got an 81 environmental score. Like, I don't till anything. Why is I got 8.6 on tillage? I haven't tilled anything. Nitrogen. I haven't put any nitrogen on, so that should be top. Well, except for the grass, of course. Nitrogen, yeah. I've always... But, well, maybe once I don't know. I don't know how that works, because I thought it was supposed to be an average score of all your fields. Even this one where I only have half and I've got stuff on it where it's still reading is 96. And the only thing is the nitrogen levels are the one that's hitting me on that one. That's the only thing that's hitting me, is the nitrogen levels is giving me a poorer score. And that one is 1, 2, 3, weed control. And I've turned weeds off now. Just now, for these, before those fields grew, because I just did not want to deal with weeds anymore. I was just like, okay, I played with weeds for, I tried it again. I tried weeds again. And it's either have them on and not spray and just take the hit on the yield, which I might do again. Just for interest's sake, maybe, because our yield here, we're getting maximum yield, actually, maximum yield, and I haven't rolled it, so that's interesting. I turn the weeds off, so I turn the weeds off, you get the boost from that. But I do mulch it. I mulch it every time, and then that's it. Then mulch it, and so I'm getting maximum yield, or maximum yield to the yield potential anyways, which is good. So, yeah. So we're going to get the worker start on this. As you can see, he fills up pretty quickly, actually. I was going to stop. Yeah, well, can always come by and clean this up with the forage collector. I have made a little adjustment or a little swap with the, I had the Lacotec on, but it would kept, made it difficult to fast farm with the mower, because it would drop, and it seemed like it was like dragging on the ground. So I've figured out, let's go over there for a second. Where are we? Here we are. So we have two Lacotecs now. One is a tool height control and one's a standard one. They both look exactly alike. I've hooked it on here already. So as a quick, what is this? 220, no. So here's the base game on the Lacotec LH2. The problem with this one was when I set the worker would lower it and it would kind of like drag on the ground and he couldn't go very fast. It would impede his fastness. So at first I thought, when I first tested the tool height control for header, modded Lacotec one, it's, as I said, it looks exactly like, and it is in all intents and purposes exactly like, except you can't lower it. And I thought it was like, oh, well, now you can't lower it. It's broken. You can't use it for other headers. I was hoping that I could use this one. to be able to raise and lower it manually, and you can't. Let me show you. There is no option or no way to adjust the height on it. Let's drop that first. Right, so let's get our, I'm sorry if I'm doing a little tutorial thing here, but there is no adjustment. It is at that height all the time. There it is. It's that is the way it is. And it's like, well, that's no good. I can't lower it. How am I going to mow or use it for anything if it's not low enough for the base game? What I was hoping to use it was put a base game, in particular a mower head, and you can be able to mow meadow grass and stuff and not just field grass. These won't do mower heads. What was it that I wanted to use it for? I can't remember now what I was. Anyways, things that we don't have the modded. Anyways, whatever. But I realized that the tool height modded headers can be in the air and still mow. And we'll show that next time we go mow. But anyways, this guy is okay. So we're gonna unload this guy real quick here, and we're gonna do a few chores in the yard because we have a few things to do since we have went ahead a month basically from the. Well, I mean, it's been a couple months since our last episode. Episode 10, it's a pretty significant little bit of... here we go. Now, let's go. Our fertilizer and production and everything has maxed out, as it were. And seeds. You know what? Actually, we're going to get... Let's get... do I have a couple... Did I leave him running? Shut him off. There we go. That's seeds. I seem to be amassing a fleet of Dootses instead of John Deeres, actually, but... That's okay. They're great for shuttling stuff around and moving because they're fast. And you can zip around with them. Pretty fun. Oh, I should have went around. Okay, let's go here first. Because this is our fertilizer. And this is seed cart. Of course. So it's just as easy to just fill these things up right from here. And let's get in our fertilizer. And we will we'll top these up at least anyways, and then they'll be full. And then we can... take the rest out with the trailer, and it looks like this guy's full. Yeah, he's full, so we can move him over, and factories are chugging along. I think we're going to look into, there is a liquid fertilizer production available, and we might, he's full, let's park him back, and we might, so this is our production area. It's still got lots of room for other productions. I don't want to produce stuff just to sell it. Like I said in the beginning, somewhere around there in the beginning, at some point, I want to be self-sufficient. And I mean, all right. I'm probably blocking him, aren't I? Yes, I am. Oh, and he missed another spot. That's the one thing. And he does, and he misses this little. I don't know why he's doing this. It's a worker. Weird. Anyways. Oh, and he has a full tank again. Wow. I'll have to go clean that up a little bit later. I think what's going to happen here is this is the longest pipe on this available on this combine. So I think we might get another combine and use that one, put a smaller header on it. The combine's been good. Seeds, yes. Let's get our seeds. right. What have we been going on? What has been going on here? Anyways, hay is just in there. I can take it out anytime. It's getting distributed over here, so I'm not worried about that. I just don't turn it on. These Hessian fermenting silos, you can remove product at will, in and out. So if I got hay in there, I can take the hay out as it is. It's a silo. It's not a factory. Factories, you put stuff in, you can only take out what has been produced. Although the lime production, apparently, I think you can take out the stones. I can't remember. I don't know why you'd want to take out the stones, though. Seed production, yeah, we're all empty again. Our solid fertilizer has maxed out. One thing nice about the solid fertilizer production, the seed and fertilizer factory, when you fill the manure and water tanks to the full, when they're empty, it's the solid fertilizer storage is full. There isn't, it's equal you put in, and it's equal to what comes out. Well, not equal as in, I mean, it's the two capacities are equal. You fill the two ingoing materials, and it will fill the outgoing material without any, like, leftover or stuff sitting there waiting or whatever, or it doesn't. Solid fertilizer, 20,000 liters almost. And our biogas plant is silage. I thought I had it. Yes, we got to turn that. We're producing so much silage, I thought I'd throw some through the biogas plant too. Why not? And digestate, we can turn that back on because we're going to drain it in a minute. And yeah, so things are moving on. We're going to empty this. The only thing about this seed factory here is the capacities are kind of low. so you can't really load it right up. However, it really produces way more than I use at this point. Yeah, so let's go. How's our cows doing? Our cows are fine. We can probably top up our biogas plant a little bit, although I think I have the slurry I gotta put in there. I can't distribute the slurry. There we go, we're full here. But we have plenty of slurry too, so that's where I think I might build a liquid. I think there's a liquid liquid fertilizer factory. I just can't remember what it uses to produce the liquid. I'm pretty sure it's slurry or manure, one or the other. The manure is not I'm not getting a ton of manure yet, but the slurry I'm getting quite a lot of slurry. Right, so we're going to just show you our slurry tanker or our slurry silo is very handy indeed. We got 91,000 liters in there waiting to be used. And it fills a bit slowly, though. That's the only thing. It's when you got that much, it does not. I might have to go with the bigger biogas plant sooner rather than later. Oh, let's see. We got plenty of room, though. I think that should be enough. I can't remember how much slurry this biogas plant takes, but right, it's going to fill up there. It does chug through it pretty quickly, though. I'll probably keep an eye on that. And, well, let's go back. Yes, he's full again. There we go. Right, so we're gonna plug away again on this, and maybe we'll check. I'll check in with you once. So I'm gonna just continue doing some cleanup chores, I'll just harvest this wheat, and we'll come back at you when we go to sell it. And as you can see, our money has gone up. We sold some milk recently, not too recently. The barley harvest was good, so that's why we're at the 2,600,000 or 567 ish. And we sold some equipment. I sold the sprayers. That's pretty much the significant one. In about 100,000+. We're probably 200 grand for selling those sprayers because we don't have weeds. Not gonna do weeds anymore. Other than that, I haven't really sold anything. Anyways, we will fade out and catch you, kind of when we're wrapping things, or just kind of a update to what's been going on before we.
Well, everybody, it is it's getting a bit dark out here, and not intentionally did it this way. However, I left my game on, and several hours later, I come back. It's like, oh, some time has passed. But not for not to worry. We're going to give this field a once around the track here with some soybeans, as I have been planting soybeans. Everywhere, and then we got a couple of chores around the yard that I have already completed a few. We have mulched this field. I don't think it needs anything else in the way of lime. It won't need any fertilizer. And so we get just like I said, we just got a couple of chores around the yard, to top up our factory, probably just a biogas plant. We're gonna top that up with some slurry and finish this off, seeding. But I need to make sure I give this thing a wide berth to for the worker to not get tangled up or anything. What else has been going on? I put up a few lights because I noticed that it was kind of dark in the yard at nighttime. Haven't spent a whole lot of time at night. farming or in the yard, but I thought it was as good a time as any. Short-term plans, Looking at another field, the field just north of us here. That would be behind me at the moment. It's got, I do believe it's got barley in it. We probably should purchase it. It's getting pretty close to being harvestable or ready to harvest. Although I would like to get on it and maybe throw down some fertilizer or something like that if that's what it needed and boost that yield. I haven't really checked on it too much as I'm busy with this. Cows are doing well. They're getting close to, well, about halfway to reproduction. So that, but we have no worries there for food or anything. We have plenty of TMR. Plenty. So, once that starts ramping up, it takes a little bit of time to get things really progressing in that respect. I don't want to just buy a bunch of barns and fill them with cows, right? I kind of want it to progress that way and kind of expand. Not too crazy fast, but keep progressively working forward. I want it to be somewhat realistic in a way. So the land's going to be about $1 million, so we're going to be knock us back down to once our soybeans come to, we can go sell our load of, I believe it is wheat. Yes, wheat. So that's, let's do that actually right now. So turn this guy around. Is that going to be enough room? Well, I guess we'll find out. Drop that down. Get him pointed in the correct and proper. There we go. Okay, he's off and going. Make sure I didn't leave any of these things running. Left them running for 6 hours. wheat, yes. What is wheat bringing these days? 17. I don't know why there's all these other sell points when the animal dealer is literally the best price every single time. Every single time. Right. Okay. Well, here we go. Let's get our lights on. Oh, that looks pretty, pretty. Pretty, pretty. Pretty, pretty in the night with the light. Roadrunner in the night with the light, with the candlestick. Not too bad with this thing when you're running with all the lights on. I don't mind so much working at night. And we'll see what 238,809 liters of wheat will put in our bank. And perhaps the purchase of said field would not be quite as damaging to our bank account as I first thought it may. There we go. Let's get that trigger to disappear. And show me the money. Oh, I should have this set up. Hold on. Oh. I'm going to miss it. Totally missed it. 400,000 plus 37,000 for in a minimum environmental score. Right. All right. So off we go then. Right. Yeah. Sorry. Let's go back to the farm. Back to the farm with you. So, actually, we're not going to need this guy right now for a bit. Oh, we can see how this guy's going to turn around here. And it seems like he's missing a little bit, but nothing we can't touch up later. Right, okay, so nope. Oh, it was this guy. I just need to get the tanker. Where am I? Ah, this, that way. That away, go that away. We need to get it. It's over the water. We might as well take it out of the cow barn. Oh, can we get? We still got some water in here. So we need to get rid of the water. And done. Ah, let's just take it out of our liquid storage. Or do we have any in there? Yeah, we should. There we go. Slurry. Right ho. There we go. And that should pop up. There we go. And empty. Let's check-a-rooney it. Slurry. Oh, can hold a whole lot more than that. It's nice, nice lighting on this tanker as well. There we go. How long is it going to take for that to fill up now? 60, well, there's 60,000 liters. It's going down fairly quick, though. Although, this, we don't need that. These guys are set. This guy's ready to, oh, he might as well drive this guy back to the farm. And we're almost there pretty quick. Oh yes, the lighting in the farm lighting. These big lights are pretty nice. Kind of light up the, we're going to throw some gravel down here at some point. I think gravel probably. Yeah, because concrete's expensive, but I don't want to be driving on dirt all the time. And where's our... he's doing good over here, mostly. Oh, missed that little spot. Right, oh, here we go. We are full, 81,000 liters in total. We have manure. We have some manure we can... transfer some of that over to other fertilizer production. We're going to end up with a whole lot of fertilizer. I think we need to look into how much do we actually have. We got a bunch in storage, and does it even have show Oh, here's sulfur. Yeah, 154,000 liters of solid fertilizer. That's quite a bit. Actually, oh, it's full, isn't it? Yes. Right. Okay, so we can leave that there for now. And we should probably go for one little more. Let's just grab them here. Catch this little spot. We have about plenty of seeds left. Yeah, we're definitely can expand our operation here. 3.4 mil. Yeah, let's buy some more land. Let's do that right now while we I'm thinking of it. And it is this piece here. It's there's one more stage left to go. Let's see, crop type. Yeah, it looks oats or sorghum. It's hard to tell. However, there we go. We're going to buy it. And then, 35. That's pretty low. Yikes. Let's purchase soil information. Right, okay. Now, pH, we're going to need to lime it. We're going to need to fertilize it. And yield is blank because we haven't in seed rates. So, lime and fertilizer for sure. Right, now we got something to do tomorrow. Because I don't think it's going to come ready to harvest in a month. We've still got some time. So we're going to let this guy go. And then we're going to, I'm going to carry on. What I'm probably going to do just off camera is just fertilize and lime and fertilize that. See if it'll take lime at least anyways. The new plot of land. And where are we? We will need to set up. Yeah, get that all set up and everything. So. Ooh, trailers. I wonder if do I have a lime? No, this is fertilizer. Oh, I should get a. What we're gonna do? We're gonna do right now is we are going to buy one of these auto one of these with lime. There we go, lime. What color should we? Oh, I guess we should make it white because lime is white. Although beige, silver. Oh, silver is a little bit more. Oh, silver, yeah, silver. Rim color. Orange. Yeah, orange. Glad I didn't say banana. Back only. Okay. Well, we got to label it now. There we go. Right. Okay, so that's good. We got something. We'll fill that up with lime. Do you believe it'll hold 20,000 liters of lime and we can spritz? So that's what we're going to do there. He's almost done, so we're gonna babysit him for a bit. And I think we'll wrap up this episode. Next episode we'll have a few things. We still got some money, so I don't know what we're gonna do with some extra money there. We might do some paving or something like that. But I'm Lily Farm Guy. a $6 million farmer. Well, I hope you enjoyed the episode. And remember, as I say, as I always say, remember, it's only a game. So till next time.